staring. This episode involves drugs. Trigger warning. When I woke up, I was in my bed at home. Fuyumi was next to me in my vanity chair, crying. "What's wrong?" I asked. Her face seemed to light up when she heard my voice. "You're awake!" she said excitedly. She then pulled me into a hug. I groaned slightly in pain. "Oh well." "I'm so sorry," Fuyumi yelled. "It's okay," I said, pretending to be forgiving while pulling her into a hug. But inside, I felt nothing but sadness and pain. In the morning, before heading to school, even though Fuyumi pretty much begged my dad to let me stay home today, I looked under my bed and had a sigh of relief. Fuyumi hadn't found my drugs when she searched my room a few months ago. I took some. Damn it, I'm nearly out. I guess I'll have to contact Toya, aka Dobby. He's the only one that understands, I thought to myself. Toya wasn't just the only one who understood. He was also my older brother, drug supplier, and the only one I trusted. My only friend. I got to school and noticed that everyone was staring at me. And I got bombarded by people from my class, Class 1A, which pissed Shoto off. "What happened Wednesday? Are you okay?" And, "Why are you at school today? We heard you only woke up yesterday," were the only sentences I could make out from the crowd of questions. I somehow made my way out from the group, so I ran to class as quickly as possible. And turns out Bakugo followed me. When he came into the class, he grabbed a chair and sat in front of my desk. "How are you?" he asked, me clearly trying to start some small talk. "I'm good. You?" I asked. "I'm okay. It's good to know you're okay as well." He carried on talking. I tuned out though. I didn't know whether he actually cared if I was okay or not. Willow, are you even listening to me? Willow! He snapped his fingers and growled angrily. "Huh? Oh, sorry. I zoned out a little bit. There. I lied. It's okay. Just don't do it again," he told me. "Okay. Sorry again," I reassured him. "Sure," he said, putting the chair back and moving to his desk. When class started, Aizawa did the register and called in present Mike for English class. Before leaving, he called me outside. Everyone stared at me again, wondering what I had done.
"Why are you at school today? We were told you only woke up yesterday," he asked.
I shrugged. "I don't know. I was just told that I was coming to school today," I replied.
"Of course. You're dismissed. Go back to class," he told me before he turned around and walked away.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this episode. It actually took me like almost 10 tries to get this right, so please, I hope you enjoyed this. Don't forget to like, subscribe, blah 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 blah, whatever you else have to do. And hope you enjoyed this. I am going to post 2 videos in 1 day because I'm moving tomorrow, which means I won't have any internet for posting. So, hope you enjoy it.